Did you know that swapping out just one shim can completely transform how your shock performs? In today's testing series, we'll make one shim adjustment to the compression double-stage shim stack, compare it with a stock setting, and dive into the results. What works, what doesn't, and why. Let's get right to it and start shimming.
First up, let's add a 44mm diameter and 0.20mm thick shim to the low-speed circuit. By stiffening it, we'll see what happens. Right off the bat, we notice a subtle but consistent increase in damping throughout all cycles. Expect about a 4% bump across low, mid, and high speeds. This tweak is ideal if you're after more bike or vehicle stability, especially when your clickers have maxed out or can't offer more compression damping. Next, we're swapping the 36mm diameter and 0.15mm thick crossover shim for a 30mm diameter and 0.20mm thick shim, making things softer. Here, the change might look subtle at first glance, but if we zoom in on the initial stroke, the difference is clear. The shock feels less stiff at the start, offering more comfort, but the peak damping remains nearly identical. Crossover shims, there's a lot to them. A small change in diameter, thickness, or both can lead to drastically different results. Now, let's tackle the high-speed circuit. We're adding a 42mm diameter and 0.30mm thick shim to stiffen things up. The results are unmistakable. We get a notable increase in damping, and the effect grows more pronounced as the testing speed increases. At low speed, it's a 10% boost, 12% at mid speed, and 9% at high speed. Perfect for improving bottoming resistance and better control at high speeds. These changes highlight how the circuits interact, because even though we treat each circuit separately, adjusting one will always influence the others, just like adjusting compression affects rebound. For our final tweak, let's swap out the 23mm diameter clamping shim for an 18mm diameter shim, softening the overall setting. Boom! Immediate results. We see a massive decrease in damping of about 34% across all testing speeds. The clamping shim has the biggest impact on damping because it sets the foundation. Everything else on the stack bends in the response to its diameter. This kind of change is perfect when you like the shock's damping character, but want to tweak the overall damping magnitude.
Remember, these adjustments are just the tip of the iceberg. Adding or removing shims, changing the diameter or thickness, and every shock, fork, and cartridge will behave differently. Experience is key here. But with the shock dyno, you can fast-track the testing process, instantly seeing how each change will likely perform, giving you the confidence to dial in the result. For more information, check out our website at lava7.com. And don't forget to drop your comments down below. We'd love to hear from you and are open to new video ideas. Thank you for watching.